Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you're just blessed today. We just want you to have a blessed, God-filled, God-directed day. We want to start with prayer. We want to pray for the direction of our nation and our world. We want to pray for our local community and region. We want to remember Cornerstone Pentecostal Church, and lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world. Maybe you have a special unspoken request, perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you, we praise you, we worship you. Father, we pray for a genuine Holy Ghost revival. We pray for a revival that incorporates the Spirit of God, the Word of God, the people of God. In this hour, in this nation, in this world, Father, we also pray for the direction of our community and our region, that you would open up doors of utterance. We could communicate this great message. We also pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. Pray that you'll open up the windows of heaven. Continue to pour out your favor and blessing on this people. And lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world, pray that you will supply each and every one of them with a hedge of protection. We ask all these things in the name above every name. Everybody said amen. Well, I don't have my Bible with me. This is going to be just a little bit different. I want to take this opportunity to thank those of you that have just shared your appreciation for these devotionals, because we just last week we crossed the 2,000 mark for subscribers. And our faithful cameraman, Brother Jordan Gazonde, is here. Brother Jordan, can you say hello?
Hello.
We want to shout, give him a shout out and pray that God blesses him over and abundantly for faithfully committing himself to be here every single day with the exception of Sundays. For recording these devotionals. So we give a big shout out for Brother Jordan Gazonde. These devotionals started very sincerely, and it was during COVID. I remember it was in March of 2020 that we started these devotionals, and our governor basically said, you're not going to have any more a gathering of 10 people or more. And the president of the United States, at that time it was Donald Trump, he got behind it and said, we're going to shut things down for a couple of weeks. So the devotionals began. We just did it basically just to keep in contact with Cornerstone Pentecostal Church and let them know that their pastor was reaching out to them and keeping everybody connected. We had a lot of new people, people that were shut-ins, people that were, of course, everything was shut down. It was just our way to keep in communication and keep a good, godly methodology of connection for God's people. Well, from that, we actually had considered maybe just shelving these daily devotionals after the restrictions began to lighten up and we could congregate. Actually, we began to congregate a little earlier than maybe we were supposed to, but we did our very best to have sanitary conditions and do things right. To where people, God's people, would not be endangered in any way, shape, or form. But it came to the place where, okay, you guys can go ahead and have church again. And there was such There were so many requests from right here in our very own congregation to continue these devotionals that that's exactly what we did. We started from zero and just kept going. And as I said last week, we crossed the 2,000 subscriber subscription list on YouTube. And so we are just continuing on. And we hope that these have been a blessing to you, that these have been just a little something to start your day with a cup of coffee. Maybe share these with somebody else. And it looks like there's a lot of people that have found them to be a blessing. So we're thankful to be able to do this. We're not, listen, I want to tell you, as a pastor, for 28 years, for 28 years, we basically, with the blessing of God and the hard work of this congregation, and the burden to just fulfill the will of God here in Spokane, Washington, we really didn't have any kind of a social media presence. And that is absolutely the truth. There may have been some people that just kind of took it upon themselves, maybe do something here, maybe put something on Facebook every once in a while or Instagram. But we really didn't have any presence on social media. We didn't have live stream. We didn't have, as far as I know, because I'm not a social media kind of person either. If I've been any kind of a social media person, it's just since we as a church have started to move in that direction. But for 28 years, we really didn't have a presence on social media. We didn't have live stream. We did have SoundCloud. We put our messages up on SoundCloud, and people, our congregation, maybe a few others, appreciated that. I want to tell you, as far as the pastor goes, we're still seeing how all of this plays out. We now live stream our Sunday services. We probably have, I don't know, anywhere from 500 to 1,000 people are watching our live streams before it's all over, said and done. And that's including the replay on YouTube. We've got our Instagram up and running. We have Facebook. We have our website is directing people in a lot of different directions. For 28 years, we had none of that. And God was able to bring us to a place where we were able to go through 5 different buildings, and we're about to go into a 6th building remodel for our education center. I'm saying all that to say this. There's a lot of people that have been critical of using social media and using live stream as a means and a mode of reaching other people. I'm not so sure of that. Then there's other people that say, yes, we need to use that. It's a great way to get that message out and expose other people to that. I'm not 100% sure about that either. I'm in the middle. I'm just being honest with you. As a spiritual practitioner, as a God-called pastor, I definitely want to reach more people. But this has never been about competition to us. This has never been about, hey, it couldn't have been, because for 28 years, we were lucky to get a phone call every now and then, say, hey, how are you guys doing way up there? And that's not a criticism, it's just a reality. So I said all that to say this: we are venturing into uncharted waters. And as long as everything is done good and appropriately, we're not gonna get wacky. We're not gonna do anything that I feel is going to is gonna compromise who and what we are. Just not gonna do that. So I just said that to say it, because that's where I'm at as a spiritual leader. I'm not absolutely 100% sure. I don't believe it's a new cart. some people are going really extreme and saying, oh, you know, you're putting the gospel on a new cart. I'm not so sure. I don't embrace that. And there's other people on the other side that are saying, well, this is the answer. This is what we need to be doing. I'm not so sure about that either. Right now, we're using what is available, and we're seeing what happens. But thank you for staying with us on these devotionals. We're just going to keep going forward. We just feel to do this. And as long as people are blessed by this, then we will continue to offer these. I'm really thankful for the additional voices here at Cornerstone that have really been a blessing, that have done our Friday mornings. We've also, Sister Mayo has done a devotion or two. Sister Flower Earls has done a devotional every once in a while. We'll ask guest speakers to do a devotional, but it's just been a great format to talk about the things of God and the Word of God. So listen, we love all of you, appreciate you, and thank you. And we'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning. God bless you.